If you're over the age of 50 and considering buying an annuity in the next 60 days, I have some important news for you. Don't buy an annuity until you understand the pros and cons of annuities. A free book to help you maximize your retirement income from television host and three-time author Josh Melberg has been released. This book reveals little-known truths about annuity strategies in simple-to-understand terms. Grab a pen right now, because we are about to offer you this free book that unlocks the five little-known secrets we believe baby boomers and seniors should know before buying an annuity. Call 800-985-1813 now, and you'll receive a free copy of Josh Milberg's book, Next Gen Annuity Strategies Revealed. As a bonus, we'll also send you a copy of The Number One Mistakes Retirees Are Making with Their Investments Today, and a free DVD on how you can get up to 33% more income in retirement. Call 800-985-1813 now. Again, that's 800-985-1813. Employees of J.D. Milberg Financial have the appropriate licenses for the products they offer.
Ladies and gentlemen, Justice Gosch, Past the Top, Jones here. Welcome. This is the USA Radio Network. Find us at 844-RADIO-US. That's 844-RADIO-US. Okay, one big story we haven't touched, and so far as the program has been ramping up, has been the Jeffrey Epstein story, and it is one of the grossest and most unfortunate stories. And there's every time I read anything about this story, I just feel like I need to go take a shower. It's just one of those deals. But there were any one of a number of Epstein accusers in the courtroom yesterday, Monday, urging the judge to keep Epstein behind bars until his trial commences. And we're talking about young women who were, there were 13, 14, 15, and 16 when they met Mr. Epstein. And now they're in their late 20s, early 30s, and they don't have a nice word to say about this guy. But the case continues to have very interesting developments. For example, over the weekend, a safe belonging to Jeffrey Epstein was searched in his New York, they call it a townhouse. At 21,000 square feet, I call that a mansion. Anyway, they find this safe. Inside the safe, well, they put it, I love the way the government puts this. Just this morning, the government became aware of a safe. Became aware, I love that, a safe that contained a pile of cash, diamonds, a passport from a foreign country with a picture of the defendant under another name. They told that to the U.S. District Judge, and the judge said, say that again? And so the U.S. Attorney said, the passport was issued in the name of a foreign country and was issued in the 1980s. It's expired. Shows a picture of Jeffrey Epstein under another name. And the passport showed his residence as Saudi Arabia. Can you say that's a rabbit passport in case he needed to get out of the country, not as himself? He had this passport sitting in his safe. So the hearing took 2 hours, and the judge said he wouldn't rule on Epstein's bail until Thursday. And, of course, you have these young women coming forward to tell their part of the story here. But when you consider what we're looking at here, this guy's been locked up in the Metropolitan Correctional Center of New York City since he was nabbed off his airplane at Teterboro in New Jersey. And he's pled not guilty. But and did you hear the conspiracy story that the New York power outage was designed to allow agents of Jeffrey Epstein to go to his house and clean out all the evidence while all the alarm systems were off? Of course, that's not what happened. Federal agents had conducted a search of his Upper East Side townhouse. 21,000 feet, it's a townhouse. They found this extraordinary volume of photographs of nude and partially nude young women, or girls, in the safe. And they think that Epstein needs to be kept locked up because he has a history of seeking to influence people. And this is one of the things I didn't know anything about. Apparently, Epstein wired $350,000 to a pair of possible co-conspirators just days after the publication of a newspaper story, and this is in the Miami Herald, alleging his sexual abuse of lots of underage young women. And the payments were made last November before any of this stuff started. But the Miami Herald had published this bombshell story about his crimes and the outrageous terms of his plea bargain. And they say that $350,000 wired to a pair of people that they're not saying who these folks are. But he wired this money to some people that might have known something. That's why they're called co-conspirators. Just days after the Miami Herald published this bombshell story, he was paying them to be quiet, and they must have known it. Because that kind of behavior, and particularly its timing, it absolutely suggests that Mr. Epstein was thinking, well, let's just say he was trying to further influence people who might know something, people who might provide information against him, in light of the allegations that were popping up in the Miami Herald. And in the court papers Epstein's people filed now yesterday, Monday, his lawyers, his defense team, proposed that his bond be secured by a mortgage on his Manhattan mansion, which is valued at $77 million, and they said his private aircraft could be pledged as collateral.
Whoa.
Now, his arrest has generated all kinds of interest on the deal that he was favored with back in 2008. Local and federal prosecutors in South Florida gave him an unbelievable sweetheart deal. And Alex Acosta, who was Trump's Secretary of Labor until he stepped down, Acosta has said in public that the deal was the best the prosecutors could do at the time. Given the willingness or the unwillingness of the local DA to indict or to indict on what charges. It's a just plain gross story. I want a shower every time I read about this thing. But here's a question. They say that since this case came back into the news that there have been any one of a number of young women who've come forward, or I guess they're not young women anymore. They're women. And when investigators find piles of cash, handfuls of diamonds, an expired passport with Epstein's picture and a fake name, all in a locked safe, the question you begin to wonder is, how many other safes are in the various other locations that Epstein could afford? If he gets out, they might never see him again. And the question always becomes, has a registered sexual predator, in the time since he was given this enormous sweetheart deal, has he disciplined himself by not engaging in any untoward behavior since the Florida deal? That's the question. Because that 14-year gap, if they can't prove that he misbehaved in those 14 years, that's a pretty elegant rebuttal to what the government's thinking. But, you know, they say that among the pictures and whatever else were some things that the federal agents really couldn't figure out what they were. They were dozens of electronic files seized in the raid on Epstein's home in New York. And they got all these pictures. So the question is, are these pictures 14 years old? Or are they new? Are they people whose names were realized, dealt with, and checked off in the original plea bargain? Or is it something more recent? And, of course, you have to wonder, the fact that he would pay $350,000 to two individuals, including a former employee, at the end of last year, that would tend to say that there might be information out there that he would very much like to keep under wraps. And remember, that money was wired after the Miami Herald reported the various circumstances of his state court conviction. And so, you just, I mean, he's in a very difficult position. He's got every motive to take it on the lam, and he's got the ability to do it too. He's got the means. So what's, and the people say that by virtue of the fact that that deal was issued, that it's possible that the courts will say that there's no difference between the Southern District of Florida and the Southern District, or the Northern District of Florida and the Southern District of New York. That if the plea bargain deal was offered in Florida under the auspices of the Department of Justice in 2008, then that still stands. It's perfectly possible that all this is just a bunch of hoopla for no reason. That is a really effective, very, very carefully and well-executed bit of journalism, investigative journalism, regarding this guy's behavior. But whether or not to grant bail, he clearly intends to fight this. And you tend to think that it's open and shut. I don't think it is. I think that he has a very good chance of beating, and I hate to say this, but I think he's got an excellent chance of beating this. And also, did you see this piece? It was the Daily Caller, where they're making the point that Epstein has isn't anywhere near being a billionaire. He has a net worth of about $560 million, which is a very tidy sum. But that's according to an asset summary that was dated June 30th, which is a week before he got arrested. And in this disclosure, listen to this, it says he owns $181 million worth of property in New York, New Mexico, Florida, and Paris. In addition to two, not one, but two private islands in the U.S. Virgin Islands. He also owns hedge funds at value at $195 million, equities at $113 million, and $57 million in cash. That's according to his latest asset summary. Can you imagine? $57 million in cash. For those of you who had a Disney upbringing, you might think about Scrooge McDuck swimming in all his money. Remember that? At any rate, it's unclear if, now I don't, when I read that summary, what I wonder is, remember the piles of cash they said they found in the safe and the dozens of diamonds? I wonder if that asset summary includes that stuff. And get this, no one seems to know how this guy came about his wealth. His only known client is the founder and CEO of Victoria's Secret, and that's his name is Leslie Wexner. And by the way, Epstein said in a 2002 profile, this was New York Magazine, that his money management firm would only work with clients with a net worth of at least $1 billion. And that was a requirement that kind of made people scratch their head, because there's all kinds of money made matching people's money, managing people's money. And Epstein held full control over his investors' money. All 150 of his employees in 2002 were administrative in nature. But the passport's what interests me. It shows a picture of Jeffrey Epstein under another name. That's particularly revealing. Anyway, Jones here. This is the USA Radio Network at 844 Radio US. Back in just a minute.
Everyone loves liberty, so why are you letting other people tell you what's best for your health care? Exercise your freedom with Liberty Health Share. Liberty Health Share is a community of people who voluntarily share one another's medical costs. Members are able to take back the freedom to make their own decisions about their health care. Stop letting others tell you what to do. Call us at 855-58-LIBERTY for more information, or check us out online at libertyhealthshare.org. That's libertyhealthshare.org.
Hi, I'm Wayne Allyn, the conservative warrior. My show, War Now, airs every day right here on USA Radio from 6 to 9 Eastern, 3 to 6 Pacific. I'm also the star of the Wayne Allyn Show on Newsmax TV, reaching over 50 million homes. And I'm a number one best-selling author of conservative books. But my favorite role is speaker extraordinaire. I was the opening speaker at many Trump for President events. I addressed over 40,000 patriots at the biggest Tea Party in the history of America. Sarah Palin and I addressed over 20,000 at the biggest Tea Party rally in the history of Nevada. I speak at Republican, conservative, and college GOP events all over this great country. And I'm available to be the star at your next event. Contact me now to arrange for a Wayne Allyn Root keynote speech or master of ceremonies at your GOP event, fundraiser, banquet, campaign rally, or college GOP event with me as your keynote speaker. It'll be the biggest hit ever. Just call toll-free 888-444-ROOT. That's 888-444-ROOT. Or email wayneroot@gmail.com.
Are you tired of high cable TV rates? Sign up for Dish today and get a $500 bonus offer while supplies last. Plus, lock in your price for 2 years guaranteed. Call All-American Dish, your Dish authorized retailer now.
800-610-5739. 800-610-5739. That's 800-610-5739. Offers require credit qualification, 24-month commitment, early termination fee, Eddie Auto Pay. Restrictions apply. Call for details.
Money, 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 money. You gotta have it. When you need it, what do? If you don't have a rich uncle, call LendingTree. With us, hundreds of banks compete for your business, so you'll get loans with competitive interest rates, and in some cases, with no closing costs. So here's the deal. If you need money, call us. Do you want to refinance your current loan? Are you 62 or older and interested in a reverse mortgage? Then call LendingTree now. 800-634-1315, 800-634-1315. We've closed over $250 billion in loans. We know what we're doing and can help you. Call right now for a free quote. 800-634-1315, 800-634-1315, 800-634-1315. That's 800-634-1315. NMLS number 1136.
What does Meals on Wheels do? They deliver meals and smiles to homebound seniors. But Meals on Wheels does something else. They turn a volunteer's lunch break into a meaningful experience.
As small and as simple as a relationship is between a volunteer and a client at Meals on Wheels, it's really so impactful. I never thought that 5 minutes could make so much difference in the lives of two people, but it has.
Drop off a warm meal and get more than you expect. Volunteer at AmericaLet'sDoLunch.org. That's AmericaLet'sDoLunch.org. Brought to you by Meals on Wheels America and the Ad Council.
With a recession ending, if you've been putting off building your business, now is the time to act. General Steel will meet or beat any price on a pre-engineered steel building of the same size and specifications. Act now before steel prices go up. So call us today for free information.
Call 800-965-1290. 800-965-1290, 800-965-1290.
If you're 85 or younger, would you like peace of mind and comfort for your family? We're Final Expense Direct with an urgent message for you. The average funeral today costs over $8,000, but the most you'll get from government benefits is $255. How will your family pay the difference? We can help. Our senior plans start as low as just a dollar a day and pay up to $30,000 for a funeral and other final expenses. Peace of mind is easy. There's no medical exam. You'll have lifetime coverage, and your plan can't be canceled as long as you pay your premiums. Call now for free information about our senior plans. Answer a few simple questions and receive approval right on the phone. Plus, call right now, and we'll give you a discount prescription card for free. Call 800-561-5716. That's 800-561-5716. Again, 800-561-5716.
Okay, how about something fun, all right? Still to come here on the program, from the dumbest things I've ever heard people do. 500,000 people say they've signed up to storm Area 51. We'll get that in just a moment, but it's just remarkably dumb. And also, how would you like to have an Amazon Home robot about waist high that can be summoned by voice tooling around in your house? Now, if you find the Amazon Echo, you know, Alexa, if you find it questionable, if you find it creepy, that's one thing. But Amazon's still working on a home robot. We'll get around to that in just a second. And also, just when you thought it was safe to go near the computer terminal again, fake news is not only real, as President Trump has established, AI is going to make fake news much, much worse. The boy who cried wolf is going to be the boy who read the news. So we'll get to that in just a moment. But first of all, how about this? Here's a great headline. If you want to live longer, drink alcohol. What? Yeah. Now, Betty Davis once said that getting old isn't for sissies. And for anybody who's experienced aging, the physical disabilities, the waning energy levels, the mental fog, I mean, we're not talking about your high school math teacher. It's not a pretty picture, but there is some good news. A new study just out of nearly 8,000 men and women aged 78 to 88 suggests the following, that drinking alcohol at an advanced age might actually increase longevity. Now, there's all kinds of studies into the harmful effects of alcohol, and they're published constantly. It's just a constant nag screen of bad news. And now comes news that a modest weekly intake of alcohol might be good for your cardiovascular function, help protect you against stroke, and I love this part, aid in fighting depression. Yeah, whoopee. A couple of shots of this and you'll be fine. On the other hand, there's all this stuff about the harmful effects of wine and beer and liquor, far outweighing any potential benefits and blah, 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 blah. Well, now we have a paper entitled Alcohol Consumption Later in Life and Mortality in the United States, just published, get this, in the journal Alcoholism Clinical and Experimental Research. Now, that sounds like a fun place to work. Alcohol, clinical, and experimental research. Well, it's for research, right, because you're in therapy, right? Sure. At any rate, this report says that researchers have found consistent associations between occasional and moderate drinking and lower mortality rates compared to lifetime abstainers. Now, maybe the abstainers just didn't have any fun and they just died of boredom. I suppose that's possible. But the idea that occasional and moderate drinking might lower your mortality rate, the thing I hate about these things is they never have any idea why the people who were doing whatever the beneficial activity was had a better time. Maybe it's just that people who take an occasional shot of whatever, or of who shot John, as John Wayne used to call it, maybe, just maybe, they're more fun-loving people, they have more fun, and for that reason, they have a better outlook on life, and maybe it's not the alcohol, maybe it's the attitude with which it's imbibed. At any rate, the occasional drinkers who consumed alcohol less than one day a week and limited themselves to three drinks daily, well, they were occasional. Moderate male drinkers imbibe 1 to 3 drinks, while females have 1 to 2. Okay, great. So the study, based on data gathered from all these people and whatever else, and basically they're saying that 1 to 3 drinks a day, 3 drinks daily for men, 2 drinks for women, that it made a significant difference. And what they say is that there may be some health conditions under which no amount of drinking would be safe. That's probably true. But the role of moderate drinking in mortality continues to be debated. Of course, the issue is, I suppose, that we all have our date with the Reaper no matter how much you drink or not. Maybe you can pour him a drink and everything. And Ace Frehley, that's right. coming up in just a moment, something ridiculous. 500,000 people signed up to storm Area 51. What if they show up? More about that in just a minute. Stay close.
I used to wonder when I saw people going into nice hotels, really nice hotels, taking a pillow with them. That was before I got a MyPillow, because I know it doesn't matter where I'm going. Whether I'm going to a 1-star, 3-star, 5-star hotel, MyPillow goes with me. Whether it's just overnight or whether it's on vacation. And here's the great deal about MyPillow right now. The lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. 2 MyPillow premium pillows for $69.98. That's only $34.99 per pillow. The lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. And it's still the same pillow. Great pillow. 60-day money-back guarantee. 10-year warranty. And call them. 1-800-951-8175, or go to MyPillow.com, use promo code USA, click on the two-pack special, and get the best deal you've ever gotten on a good night's sleep when you get a MyPillow.